Hi folks, welcome back to part 17. Here we go, we're going to drop in our Operation Red Witch. We need to stop the Advent retaliation and it's going to be pretty hard going. We lost a grenadier and Mora is injured, so we're going to be bringing with us Erin Johnson, who is only a squaddy, but still has a grenade launcher, has the advanced grenade launcher and the special advanced grenade launcher that we've got, which will do increased shredding and area of effect. So hopefully she's going to do really well for us. We got one decision that needed to be made about Dave, who's now been upgraded to a major, which is wonderful. And I've decided, I've decided that rather than continue to push on, we could go field surgeon, reduces the wound recovery time, which is nice. Savior, which restores additional hit points, and restoration, which means you can go around to every single person. I'm actually going to push down the support role side for Dave. I really want Dave to be able to be useful other than just for healing. And I feel like most of the important healing related stuff we've already got, like medical protocol itself is super important because it means a gremlin can go out and heal remotely. And then we've got field medic giving us additional charges and revival protocol. So with those things, that really fulfills most of the roles that I need Dave to be able to cover for us when it comes to healing. And once we get that proving ground project research, which is going to increase the ability, the actual amount that the med kits are healing, it's going to mean that we don't really need Savior. And so I just feel like having Call Under Pressure and then going into Ever Vigilant and Sentinel are going to be much more useful for us in the day-to-day running of our mission, so let's definitely grab that. And that's the way that we're going to go now with Dave. Apart from that, we've got the same squad as we had just a moment ago. Let's just quickly double check. We haven't got enough allies. No, we don't. Anything else that we need but comp? Anything else that we want to bring? Doesn't look like it. All right, let's get down there. Oh, actually, there was something nagging at me and I couldn't think of what it was. We really want to take some battle scanners, so I'm going to do that. And yeah, let's do it, let's go. We'll leave the tracer rounds at home for this mission.
Deploy. In position to drop.
We just got word the aliens are hitting a resistance outpost with everything they've got, and our people don't stand a chance against them. We're heading in to secure the area. Eliminate all enemy contacts.
All right, this is going to be challenging. Got to rescue at least 6 civilians. This is going to be our first of the traditional style resistance retaliation, the alien advent retaliation mission. So we want this to be successful.
Hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot, and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Right then. A quick look around. Got one civilian here. Can't see any others at the moment. We do have hands. So the rest of the squad isn't, as Central was just saying, the rest of the squad isn't concealed, but of course hands is. Which is great. So we'll move hands up. And we'll start to get some visuals on the area. Right, let's go there. There's cover from two directions there, so he should be safe. Okay, awesome. Next thing I want to do is move Daniel up into a nice position for some future sniping and chuck scanner out. So this scanner is going to tell us if either of those civilians is in fact problem. Alright, that's good news. That means that we can just run up and collect those civilians. Okay, we need to push up pretty fast and hard because we've got a lot to achieve on this mission.
Running.
As it pertains to rescuing civilians. So I'm going to move the whole squad up on double moves. Into cover, of course. We're hoping one of these civilians doesn't get shot. Uh-oh.
I've got eyes on an advent position.
Berserker, a drone, and a sentry. Advent engineer. Okay, there's two civilians over there. Sorry, Isabella, we couldn't save you. Okay, so we should have pretty good shots. That lot. We're really not wanting to reveal hands, so we can get hands to rescue this person here. Nice. And then move on up to here. Rescue that second one. Nice. And give us some eyes over that direction as well. No other contact out there. Okay, so that's quite good. Let's get the area suppression or something going on. Good old Sergei. Let's move you up to there, Sergei. Now, I wanted to see him. Yeah, exactly. So is that area suppression going to affect... Doesn't look like it's going to cover Berserker as well, which is a real shame. Okay. The only other holo targeting we've got is on hand, and he's not going to have a turn. I'll go this turn. Alright. We need to take this thing down hard now. All right, Aaron.
Moving to position.
Gas grenade might be good here.
Heads down.
Yeah. Gas grenade. It will poison it as well, which is important. Oh no, wow, how lucky are we that that didn't get Aaron? Wow, that was pretty bad. That was some explosion. Look at that. Where's Hans? He's over there. He's okay. Alright, we're okay, people. We're okay. Crap, that was really bad. But Erin, how come you've got another action? Is that thanks to... Oh, you don't. Oh, it's pretending that we've got another action.
On the move.
Maiden. Alright, we've got to start putting the pain on this Berserker. That's a nice, nice effort. Okay, Sergei. can now get the Berserker again, which is excellent. Are we getting Executioner? We are. Okay, that's what I was waiting for. Alright, let's take that 40% crit. Come on, Daniel. Beautiful. Oh, I didn't really want to bring Leo. Oh, made maybe a little bit of a mistake here in bringing Leo. I don't think it's all that necessary, actually. I want to start training up another gunner as soon as possible to have Shred for those times that we don't have Barky with us. Alright, finish that off, Leo, please. Perfect.
That's right.
Yeah, alright, if you could suppress, please. That's good. That's got both of those at the back there. Blue, you can move up.
Heading out.
Five to seven with a 40% crit. Yeah, let's take that. Not comfortable with where I've left Blue there. It's just very flankable and a bit of a concern, actually. Okay, now this guy. Oh, this is a big problem. Look out, Blue. Oh, crap. Wow. Wow. Oh, what was I thinking? That is. Oh, no. That was such a rubbish mistake. Oh, okay. Well, let's stabilize. So we've got one of the cool mods I mentioned at the beginning of the campaign that we've got is allowing us to stabilize, and it makes perfect sense to me. Blue has got medkits, so a soldier that's nearby can use the medkit of that soldier to stabilize them. Okay, so Blue is back. Blue is okay now. Wow, that was just not good. Take the 40%. It's going to give us holo targeting as well. Yeah, that'll teach it. Oh, no, I just... That was really, really bad. See, what I was expecting to happen was Blue to be able to take one of those two targets down and then the suppression or overwatch be able to deal with the other one. But I just didn't look at the amount of health that they had. It wasn't good. It was just after playing fairly well a fair amount of the time, just these little mistakes you get so punished for. Quite rightly, I love the fact that this game is challenging, but it's just I'm grateful that Blue is alive still, so I just you know, can't help but feel like a right idiot for doing stuff like that. All right, you got any shots, Daniel? No. Okay, you can push on up then, mate. We got over there, I've got a sentry that I think we're only seeing that sentry because of hands. Yeah, so there's three of them over there. Daniel, how far can you throw one of these battle scanners, man? Not bad. Bad at all. Okay. Uh-oh. Well, that's why we brought the battle scanners.
We've heard rumors about some kind of shapeshifters. I'm guessing this is it.
It is a remarkable species. If only we had some means of containment.
Don't even think about it.
Okay, it can't see us just yet. I'm gonna move hands up to here. Okay, it might be. Ooh, crap. Well, I was gonna say it might be time to reveal hands in a second. We could have more contact than we can handle if hands gets revealed, so. That was potentially going to be okay, but it isn't. Alright, I'm going to move hands back here and not put him on Overwatch. We want to make sure we don't reveal anything else this turn. So let's play a little bit cautiously. Is that going to reveal that monster? It is. So let's not go there. A bit hot over there. I'd love to be able to put Leo on Overwatch, but not a good spot for him. Actually, how about that? That looks okay, actually. Yeah, that's not going to trigger anything.
Roger that.
Beauty baby, that will trigger that beast. How about that? That's not safe either. That's okay, though.
On your order.
Alright, and then we'll engage next turn. We might lose a few civilians this turn, though, which is a bit disturbing. Another berserker. Oh, Dolly. At least it was all over quickly, Dolly. Two sidewinders as well. Okay, here comes this pod. It's going to trigger now, is it? What's the face this going to do? Nice work. It's on fire as well. Unlucky. It's alright, Aaron. We're not expecting too much of you at the moment. Uh-oh. That's bad. I'm glad I moved hands back now, though. Oh, missing a few shots here. Okay, let's trigger that other pod because hands has now been spotted. At least it's in the enemy turn. Yeah, that thing's on fire, which is helpful. Now then, gotta think about this turn. There's another pod out here which we want to avoid triggering. Is that a gas pump? Well, that's gonna help us deal with that sentry. Although I was hoping to grenade this area so we could deal with that engineer. I might still want to do that. Can we? Yeah, we can shoot that. Yeah, I'm gonna take that shot with hands. Get rid of that sentry. See you later. Now then, Erin, we're gonna want you to move up and grenade that in. How's that? That looks pretty good.
Confirmed.
Please get food and blow a hole in his cover as well. That would be nice.
Here, catch.
Funky looking equipment you got there, Aaron. Wait. Free reload for hands. For Sergei.
Продолжим.
Alright, so it's burning 1-3 damage over time, can't use abilities. So Sergei, just move on up, mate.
With he goes.
Just shoot that thing. Alright, that's a faceless down. Excellent. Hoorah! Yeah, nice work. Yeah, we can kill that guy with combat protocol, which is nice. So then,
let's move
Aiden up. Nice to have him in, on point, really. Alright, well, we can take that guy down with 90% chance of success. Absolutely. As well. Okay, still nothing here. So let's move you up to there, please. We'll leave Leo till last, just in case this shot misses. Which it doesn't, that's nice.
X-ray neutralized.
Okay, so you can now go on Overwatch then, Leo. Here comes that pod, are they going to walk in on us? Oh! Okay, we know there's a pod there, and there's a Berserker pod up the top there. Come on, wander into our area, please. We want to get eyes on them. No, that's a shame. So what do we want to do here? Do we want to activate that pod? Okay, we've lost 4 civilians. We've got to rescue 4 more and there's 7 surviving. The cover and stuff around here there is. We're quite far back, some of us though, from there. We're running out of grenades. I'm as much as we don't really have much time, I'm tempted to do a bit of a reload, an Overwatch turn.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I think that that is what I'm gonna do here.
Okay.
Yeah, готов.
You move, no, so you can reload and steady your weapon.
Locked and loaded.
Aiden, just the Overwatch, please. Overwatch. We can't do this for any more turns than this one. But it's nice to have the luxury of doing this maybe for one turn.
I'm on it.
Now, we're really hoping something wanders up over to us. No. Shit, we just lost another person. Alright, we've got to push up. Run out of our scout, and we have also no longer got any battle scanners, so that's
moving out.
Nothing. All right.
Edo.
Shown on the X.
Heading out.
We already exploded that, didn't we? It's not going to explode a second. It doesn't look exploded, whereas that one does. That's... Oh well, let's keep going on up.
On the move.
Scanning.
Ясно. Начинаю наблюдение.
Нет, geht nichts.
Come and get some. Moving to position. Overwatch.
Oh, they're just murdering civilians. Murdering. Oh, I hope that extra turn hasn't cost us this match. Yes. Okay, cool. Lucky. Okay, we've got holo targeting on it now.
Negative damage.
Come on, the rest of the team. Get him. Oh, look at how horrific it is. I'd shoot it in the legs. It looks like those legs will go much easier. All right, we're going to be bold and aggressive here. Even better would be a grenade on it, because the grenade... Oh, I've just got a grenade here. The grenade will both hurt the beast. Additionally, from hurting the beast, it will blow up a thing, which will further hurt it. So let's just take that. Who are you, Mr. Berserker? Oh, he's cranky. Yes. Okay, Erin, heavy cover for you. 84, lovely. 12 damage, you're a hero. Nothing on fire now. Oh, sadly not. It's just enraged. That's on one health, which is a shame. But it's not just dead, you know. Daniel, right, what else we got going on here then? Thinking a good old fashioned Sergei suppression will be nice. Oh, we only got two of them. I thought we were going to get that Sidewinder at the back there as well. Now, I want you to get that Sidewinder, please. Seems like a big crazy move, and it may be. Oh, we're burning now. Why did that flesh not work? Ow. Rubbish. What? He cancelled the move. Because he's on fire now. Oh. Bloody hell. Alright, let's see if we can shoot that thing down. Come on, Daniel. 3 damage from a dodge. This is going really not going well now. Okay, so that one at the back is not suppressed and we need to take it down. What's the range of this run and gun? It's not bad, but we can't get a flank on it, which is what I would really like to be able to do. Okay, so we've only got you two left now. This might have to be a crazy, superbly bold and slightly loony maneuver. No, I don't know that that's a good idea. All right, Hans, move up here, mate. Curse you for setting yourself on fire, man. Can't you? At least you can take that down. Okay.
Getting in close.
Alright. Come on, Aiden. We've got civilians to be rescuing here. Yes! Beautiful. You're a machine, my friend. Alright, let's see what they do. So the Sidewinder is suppressed. Uh-oh. Vectoid puppeteer with a glowing green something inside its body. Sergei missed. What happened to close combat specialist? Hello? Hello, close combat specialist. Oh my god. Is he out of ammo or something? Or did that just bug out? Oh, mate. This is such a rubbish. He's got loads of ammo. Oh, that. I just feel totally cheated. That's bogus, man. That's absolute nonsense. That's loads of rubbish. So we have to we must kill things very quickly because old Hans is on fire. He's on fire and he's taking a lot of damage. One more turn of taking up to 3 points of damage. That's gonna put, we're gonna have a lot of badly wounded people after this mission. So we've got combat protocol. We are currently flanked by some of these jokers. Oh, can't quite get into cover over here, which is a shame. That guy back there, that advanced soldier, is flankable. We're not in range. So, have you used your free reload? You have. That, like, is that a good move? Only gives us view of one of them. Okay, we're in a bit of trouble here. Where's Hans? Okay, he can't do flesh at the moment because he's on fire. So the best Hans has got is a move and shoot style attack. So I think we're going to use Hans to go here and hit that sidewinder. Or possibly here and hit that sidewinder, which opens up Aiden for doing something a little bit more crazy. Oh, Aiden is really hurt. Oh, of course he is. Oh no. You get right over there to full cover. That doesn't help too much though. You can take down that sectoid. Aaron, what can you do here? Get a flank shot on that guy. Okay, so that means we need to be this side to get the flank shot. Person. That's too far out. Oh, a bit of a tricky spot. Sergei's flankable from there. He hasn't got enough for a suppression. Not a lot of good cover available. Leo, 37% on that. Daniel moves, he's going to lose his sniper shot, of course. Oh dear. All right, Leo, you go there. Sergei, move up. We need to get those people into cover, so that's quite an easy thing for us to figure out. flankable by the sidewinder, but we mind about that too much. Daniel, you can move on up. So we want Hans, where are you, mate? Over here. Okay, so Hans, we want you to take down this sidewinder. Now, if you can actually kill it, that would be very nice, please. Perfect. Okay, that's great. Now that frees up Aiden. Frees up Aiden maybe to do that move. Now let's have a think about that. 98% chance to just kill that thing outright. He is then flankable by either of those two. They would have to redeploy though. So if we put down enough overwatch, that might be okay. Right, that is a bit risky, of course. Let's go there, Aaron.
Resistance has done everything it can to convince people to join the cause, but it's an uphill battle when you've got Advent whispering propaganda in your ear 24 hours a day.
Well, thanks for that, Bradford. I thought that was another pod being triggered. Oh, wow. That would have been absolutely terrible for us. Okay, so we've got a grenade on that guy. You know what? Okay, that might be the move to take. Have we got anyone who can flank him then? Yeah, we've got a nice shot on with Leo from that position. If you can take that, you can take that cover away. Which then leaves not too much more to deal with. I like that. Now then, let's see.
Only a 37, he's now behind heavy. What the crap just happened? He was behind half cover, and now he's behind heavy cover after we've blown up his bloody cover?
We're getting pretty unlucky here, gang. We're getting pretty unlucky. Obviously what's happening is he needs to step out that way. If he steps out this way, that tree must be blocking his line of sight. So stepping out this way means he can't get that flank shot on after all. So he's now needing to step out that way, which means that he's along that line and he's getting heavy cover. That's a joke. That's a f- okay, got pistol overwatch. So the question is, do we do the crazy? And we've lost the aid protocol. Oh no, we still got aid protocol, okay. Oops, I was wondering if aid protocol on Aiden might be the way to go. Aaron, what have you got? You've got bugger all, so you're going to literally have to overwatch. It might just be everyone on overwatch here, and we are going to need to worry about what that sectoid's going to do to us. But I am pretty scared about getting Aiden in so close when he's on not very much health, so I think it's too much of a risk probably.
I'm on it.
I would love to be doing some kind of heroic maneuver, but I don't think it's appropriate really right now. All right.
Scanning.
We might as well take that flank 100%. 5 damage, that is nice. Now, who is it we want to put on protection duty? Yeah. Or do we just want to... We probably want to overwatch. Oh, lovely, Aiden. Lovely, 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 lovely.
Target neutralized.
Lovely. Someone. Yes!
Miss the target!
That's how it's done.
Difficult decisions being made here. Oh, look out, Sergei! Wow! Half cover. We know those advanced soldiers do a lot of damage. Okay, are you no longer on fire now? Still on fire. Got a flank shot on this guy. Oh, he's, his tree just melted itself. That's pretty nice. Alright. Sort this guy out, please, mate. That's okay. Don't mind that. Aaron, if you could finish him off, that would be awesome. Nice. Now, is that the last pod, please? Please let that be.
Enemies down.
Yes. Something nasty's coming. It's another one of those faceless things. Right. So, how are things looking here? That's good. We're moving into places without cover because it's pretty much safe to do so. That thing doesn't have a ranged attack.
On your order.
90%. Let's take that, Aiden. Anyone else got shots on? 88, let's take that. Nice. Wow, that was a tough one.
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're
terrible.
Not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear.
Thanks, Bradford.
Confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Thanks, Bradford. Nice to see the promotion on hands as well. But that was just a bad, bad move with Dave there. Like, thank goodness Dave didn't die from that, because that was entirely my fault. Moving up into that flank position and not really just assuming that we could deal with both of those targets. It was foolish. We really paid for that. Blue's going to be out for a long time, which is going to have knock-on consequences for the rest of the gang. Oh well. These things happen. Nobody died. It's always a good day when no one dies. Oh, Dave, what have I done to you? Still, promotion for hands is very nice. We're building hands as a sword-based, extreme kind of post-combat person, and I think Blade Storm is a great one to have for that. All right, just one promotion. A lot of people wounded. Two more berserker corpses. A bunch of other corpses. Fine, we'll take those. Faceless autopsy now available. Unstaffed engineer, huh? Well, we're going to need to put an engineer in the power relay. Just check what the upgrade does. So the upgrade gives us 2 power, 80 supplies.
Power relay upgraded.
That's nice. So we've now got 2 power spare. How much power do we need to install the thing we want to put in here? Resistance comms, that's what we want to put in here. Insufficient power. Okay, so we are going to have to install Charlie, for example, in there. Thanks, Charlie. Now then, we can build the resistance comms in there as soon as we've got enough supplies. Okay, 160 supplies. I also want to upgrade the guerrilla tactics school so we can start to you start to get a leader's place. 20 days till plated armor. You can see that we're really in need of getting this plated armor, because when we're taking damage now, sometimes we're getting killed outright by like 7 damage and stuff like that coming in. It's pretty bad. So we've lost a couple of people who have taken kind of their maximum points of damage, and getting this is going to really help. They make up for in grit. Start work on that machinery, please. Nice. Right, so we need more money. Maybe a trip over to the black market is a good shout. Resistance contacts, that's not. Five to 7 days. That. Oh, we're already building a radio relay here. Let's just check out the ability that we'll get from that. Quick procro, black market items, 33% less intel. That is nice. Inspiring for Oceania. Oh, intel rewards increased by 25%. That's nice too. Alright, well, let's. Are we close to the black market? I do want to go there and just check out what's going on over there at the moment, and then we'll fly back down and finish off that radio relay. What do they want? They want advent lockbox. I'm happy to sell a couple of lockboxes. We're pretty tight on the research at the moment, so advent trooper corpse. Yes. Wow, we're doing well then. Should have quite a few trooper corpses for sale. Advent trooper corpses, 37 for 6 each. Brilliant. Well, let's sell like down to 15 of them. What else do we need them for? Nanoscale vest, I mean, who cares? Let's sell a bunch of those. We'll sell 2 of those lockboxes. It's giving us quite a tidy amount of money here. Oh, I didn't put that new bit of bloody armor on. Okay. Keep it cool, please. Keep it cool. Just had a couple of tough bits here and there. Now I'm just noticing that tone of stress or whinging is creeping in, and I will not allow it. We've got to keep going with the best attitude we can muster. We need those faceless corpses a lot. Those Valyrian crystals, which is cool, but we need to save those up. Advent officer corpses, let's sell a few of those. Unanswered corpses, yeah, let's sell give those two. Five corpses, we're going to need some of those, but we'll sell a few. Alright, 300 squillions. That is very nice. Now, let's see, we probably don't want to be buying much at the moment because the intel costs. Oh. Yeah, look, I think the intel costs have doubled. Maybe in the black market. I don't think that's just applying to the resistance contacts. As much as I would love to get advanced auto loader, laser sight, etc., we don't want to spend that much intel. We really need everything that we've got at the moment. So we made a fair bit of cash out of that. So.
New orders, Commander?
Let's get the resistance comms going.
Communications facility construction initiated.
Now, who do we want to put in there to help us build that? Yeah, you can leave this. It's Adriana. Get Adriana in there, making that happen quicker. Nice.
I wonder if this is what it was like in the old days. Always on edge, ready for a fight on a moment's notice. Certainly keeps you on your toes.
Oh, it does. Okay. Oh, it costs us 2 power as well.
Guerrilla Tactics School facility upgraded.
That's nice. Yeah. So, I want to either put Dave in here or Sergey, I think. We've got so many people wounded right now that I don't want to take anyone. I don't want to take Sergey out of the roster at the moment because we've got too many people wounded for too long. So, we'll just push on for now. Maybe what we could do, maybe we could start, actually, why don't we start training Sinead? It's just to kind of keep them up close person. Once, okay, get some, or collector, once permission, spend all action to grant all allies within command range a plus 20% bonus critical hit chances. That's nice. All right, we're going for collector. Any non-human enemy gives us 50% chance to grant 1 point of intel. So we'll get a training. Alright then, push on exploring those supplies for now. We're going to push on building this radio relay. For Indonesia. Amazing! Welcome, Joe. Welcome indeed. Alright, so we want to put somebody else in there now. Look at him. What a hero. Does not care. Goes out wearing some skimpy little shorts into battle. Couldn't give a flying one. Alright. Let's go. A lot more story about him. Come back to. Alright, so got a little bit more money. I do want to buy a new recruit. That'd be Mr. Daly. Another hero amongst. Alright. So, we definitely need a ranger. Let's get you doing that, please, Mike. Hopefully you're going to fare better than the rest of our rangers so far. Right, new project for the Proving Ground. Nice, we've got plasma grenades. That is so good. Alright, do I want battlefield medicine next? Or are we going to want this gold jack? Well, we're running low on supplies now, so we'll just hang in there for the battlefield medicine. For now, we could do the Skulljack, which is going to be important for advancing the storyline. Or we could let's go for an ammo. Yeah, let's go for an ammo. I do like the funky ammo stuff. And then as soon as we've done that, we're going to get Skulljack. I'm just going to spend the money on the Skulljack now to queue it up. It means we don't have to keep coming in and out of the Proving Ground. Lovely. A funky new radio. Oh yeah.
Welcome to the fight.
Boom. What's up, Bradford? Latest technology.
The resistance.
That's also increased the income to 108 supplies, and that's also reduced the cost of contacting Australia. Sadly, we are at 3 out of 3 contacts at the moment, and we need to get this resistance comms facility built in order to do that. What we are going to do though is maybe we might be able to cheat a little bit by getting this resistance contact here from scanning at this location, which would be totally perfect. All right, let's go.
We've got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
Boom. You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
Thanks, man. Wow, this actually was a very successful month, and it did not feel like it. Oh well, we did. We look at all these missions and things that have gone really well for us. That's wonderful. New alien facility just round the corner. Next retaliation is going to be some way away. Two hidden events that are going to cost us a lot of intel if we want to find out what they are. Decreases the next supply drop by 50. So that's not the end of the world. One of these two could be bad, but we can't justify spending 60 intel to reveal that. Do we need that money now? Oh, we do need supplies. But I don't want this to disappear. Bloody far away. All right, let's go and get the supply drop. It's only going to take us 3 days to pick it up, and then we'll come back and grab that. Hopefully it's still there. We do need supplies at the moment. Okay, mission. Neutralize a target. 199 supplies and 89 intel.
Setting course for India.
Just doing a lot of flying all over the ship at the moment. Wonderful, Sparky is back. Back in action. Okay. Alright, as always, I'm going to leave it there for now. I hope you enjoyed this one. And please forgive me for nearly killing Dave. That was really bad. But I will see you all very soon for the next one. We've got plasma grenades now. Nice.